coming to you from our GIS studios, I am Anicia Antoine, and this is your Midday News Brief. In keeping with the government of St. Lucia's plans to build a resilient St. Lucia, the essential desilting works on the John Compton Dam are finally starting with Phase 1. The first component included the preparation and construction of the sediment disposal area and building and repairing of access roads at the site, which will be done by local contractor Mega Contracting Inc. The second component will include the dredging of the reservoir and installation of pipes to the sediment disposal area downstream. The Honorable Ezekiel Joseph recently announced the completion of the Saltfish Road project. Constructed under the Constituency Development Program, Saltfish Road in Babonneau now facilitates easier and more convenient access for residents, especially in times of emergencies. St. Lucia's champion sprinter Julien Alfred is the recipient of a full scholarship from the University of Texas at Austin. Alfred brought home St. Lucia's first ever Youth Olympic Games medal when she finished second overall in the women's 100 meters in Buenos Aires, Argentina last October. She paid a courtesy call to the office of the Prime Minister before leaving for university. From the government and people of St. Lucia, we wish her all the best. St. Lucia's 40th year of independence celebrations is set to be an exciting year of major activities. According to Senator Fortuna Belrose, who is the minister with responsibility for culture and creative industries, 40 is a number of great significance, and she called on St. Lucians at home and abroad to celebrate the occasion with all the pomp and ceremony deserving of such an occasion. After a devastating early morning fire that destroyed several homes in the area, residents of Rosehill are grateful for the assistance given to them by Volunteer Saint Lucia and the Ministry of Equity. Volunteer Saint Lucia donated food, clothing, and household items. Join us later on NTN for Nation Beat, where we bring you today's top stories. Thanks for watching.